बिस्मिल्लाहिर्रहमानिर्रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। माय नेम इज़ ज़ैन एंड आई एम अ स्टूडेंट ऑफ कॉमसेट यूनिवर्सिटी इस्लामाबाद। एंड टुडे माय टॉपिक इज़ एडवेंट ऑफ इस्लाम इन सब कॉन्टिनेंट थ्रू मुगल एम्पायर। डिड यू नो हाउ वाज मुगल एम्पायर फाउंडेड? एवरीवन नोज दैट मुगल एम्पायर वाज वन ऑफ द बिगेस्ट एम्पायर्स इन द वर्ल्ड, बट वेरी फ्यू नोज दैट हाउ मुगल एम्पायर वाज फाउंडेड। सो इन दिस टॉपिक वी विल डिस्कस हाउ मुगल एम्पायर वाज फाउंडेड and how Mughals conquered the subcontinent and raised Islam. Did you know who was Babur? Babur was the first emperor of Mughal dynasty from 1526 to 1530 in the subcontinent, and he is the founder of Mughals empire. Babur, the Mughals dynasty founder, only ruled as emperor for roughly 4 years, from 1526 until 1530. He was a prominent genius who had mastered the art of leadership. Babur conquests the throne of Fergana, which was spread over Kyrgyzstan, Tajikistan and Uzbekistan at the age of 12. But he faced rebellion. He conquered Samarkand, city of Uzbekistan, after 2 years, but lost Fergana soon after. He again fights to recapture the Fergana, but he lost, and he also lost the control on Samarkand. After that, in 1504, he attacked on Kabul and succeeded, which was under the protective rule of Abdul Razak Mirza. Babur formed a partnership with the Ismail I, ruler of Safavid Iran, and reconquered parts of Turkestan, including Samarkand. But he again lost Samarkand for the third time. After losing the Samarkand for the third time, Babur turned his attention to Indian subcontinent. Babur's first conquest into India began, and in the Delhi Sultanate controlled region of Punjab. Ibrahim Lodi dynasty was Grand Sultanate at that time. Babur attacked to Ibrahim Lodi in 1526 at Panipat. This battle is also known as the First Battle of Panipat. In this battle, Babur also received artillery aid, the aid in which one gives weapons to other, from Turks of the Ottoman Empire. Therefore, Babur defeated the Ibrahim Lodi Delhi Sultanate and entered the subcontinent. After the victory over Delhi Sultanate, Babur received threats from Rana Sangha of Mewar, Rajasthan, and Afghans ruling eastern India. Babur attacked and conquered the Rajasthan by defeating Rana Sangha of Mewar on March 16, 1527. This battle is also known as Battle of Khanwa. Moving on, the next opponent, Babur shifted focus to the Afghan chiefs who had captured the city of Lucknow during his conflict with Rana Sangha. Babur attacked the Afghans, who were led by Muhammad Lodi, brother of Ibrahim Lodi. This battle is also known as Battle of Ghagra. Babur again got victory over Mahmud Lodi and Afghans. Mughal Empire had now spread through much of northern India. Babur died in 1530. Then his elder son Humayun took the crown, but he had temporary complications in 1540. When he was deposed by the Afghans ruler Sher Shah Suri, but eventually he was able to regain his leadership role in 1555. After defeating the Sher Shah Suri, but unfortunately he died in the following year by leaving the next phase of Mughal Empire in the hands of his 13 years old heir Akbar. From 1556 through 1605, Akbar prompted a variety of major changes within the empire and extended Mughal Empire over most of the Indian subcontinent. He reformed and strengthened his central administration and centralized his financial system and reorganized tax collection processes. He took an active interest in other religions, persuading Hindus, Parsis, and Christians, as well as Muslims, to engage in religious discussion before him. This is the map of Akbar's time, subcontinent. After the death of Akbar, Jahangir and then Shah Jahan took control of Mughal Empire, and this chain went on. So I hope you have learned something from my little effort. Allah Hafiz.